kutoka hayo machozi.
We are talking about divine lifting. Amen.
Amen.
God is able to lift us to new levels. He is able to do what no man can do. You know this song, God of Wonders? Because he works wonders. God of Wonders, Yahweh, we glorify your name, Adonai. You reign, and forever you will be our God, Yahweh. We bow to worship you. Lift up your hands and say, oh God of wonders, do wonders in my life. Let it be known through my life, through my testimony. Let it be known that you are God of wonders in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout amen. Hebrews chapter 7 verse 12, 13 and 14. That's what I want us to begin today. Hebrews chapter 7 verse 12, 13 and 14. The Bible says, for the priesthood being changed of necessity, there is also a change of the law. For he whom these things are spoken belongs to another tribe from which no man has ever officiated at the altar. For it is evident that our Lord arose from Judah, of which tribe Moses spoke nothing concerning priesthood. When we talk of divine lifting, we are talking of a lifting that cannot be explained. A lifting that no man takes pride in. A lifting that when God picks you up, nobody will claim any glory. Nobody will say, I helped her. When we talk of divine lifting, we are talking of lifting by grace. Grace means an expected favor, an unmerited favor, where no man takes glory, but God alone takes the glory. I came to speak to somebody tonight that a divine lifting is coming, that nobody shall claim glory for it. Somebody shout yes. I came to speak to JBC Wagige that God is about to do something here, that nobody can take glory for it. That God is about to do something in the church, that nobody shall take glory for it. Somebody shout yes. And the people will come to church, people will worship the Lord even without anybody telling them to come, so that nobody shall take glory. Somebody shout yes. The Bible says in Hebrews about Jesus, the scripture is talking about Jesus, that Jesus has become the high priest in the order of Melchizedek. And now the Bible says, for Jesus to become a high priest, for him to be enabled to become a high priest, something had to change. Why? Because he is from the tribe of Judah, and the priests are not from
from the tribe of Judah. Priests are from the tribe of Levi. So Jesus naturally does not qualify to become a high priest, but because God has said that Jesus will become the high priest, something has to change. Shout hallelujah. And so the Bible is saying, for Jesus to become a high priest, the priestly lineage had to change. It is only the family of Aaron that qualified to become priests. Am I talking to somebody here? But now God comes and picks his son and says, you are not born in the house of Aaron. You are not born in the lineage of Levi. But I have chosen you to become a high priest in the order of Melchizedek. And so the Bible says, the priesthood had to be changed for Jesus to become a high priest. The system had to change. And when the system of priesthood changed, the law had to change. I come to announce tonight, there are things that must change for you to go up. There are systems that the people are put that are in order for somebody to prosper. There are system people are put, and they say, for you to prosper, you have to have a degree. For you to prosper, you have to have a master's. For you to prosper, you have to go to school. The Bible says, when God picked up Jesus, he put aside the law and said, keep aside the law. I am about to lift my son. I came to announce tonight, things must change. Laws will change for us to rise up. Laws will change for us to rise up. I don't care where you are born. When God picks you up, everything stands aside. Shout yes. Lift up your hands and say, I shall be lifted. Shout, I shall be lifted. You know, there are systems that the people have always put for a church to grow. There are seven keys, seven laws that must be obeyed. I came to announce tonight, God is putting aside the laws. God is putting aside the laws so that Jesus can climb up the ladder. Every system they put that limits you, that puts you down. Every system they put that puts a limitation. I came tonight to say, hell must be removed. Hell must be removed. Somebody shout yes. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah!
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 The Bible says, for the priesthood, because the priesthood was changed, the law had to change. We fought ya kwamba sheria ya Musa haiwezi badilika. In fact, you could never try even to change a letter in the law of Moses. The Bible says, when Moses read the law, his face was shining with the glory. Why? The law was glorious. But when God says, it is time to lift my son, the law was put aside so that Jesus can rise. I come to announce tonight, every law
that is limiting you, every law that is limiting you, let it be put aside. Shout yes! Shout yes! And the Bible says, the lineage where Jesus came from had never been spoken about of anyone becoming a priest from the house of Judah. Lift up your hands and say, I shall become the first. Lift up your hands and say, I shall become the first. The impulse is telling us the lineage of Jesus had never been spoken of ever producing a priest. It is nowhere in the records that in the lineage of Judah anybody tried to become a priest, because it was impossible for anyone in the lineage of Judah to become a priest. The Bible says it was impossible for anyone from the house of Judah ever to become a priest. But when Jesus came, Makakapazaya, when Jesus came from the lineage of Judah, a priest is rising up. I am declaring tonight, from your clan, a millionaire can rise. From your family, a millionaire can rise. I am declaring tonight, you can be the first. Shout yes! Shakabozia. Somebody is becoming the first in Jesus' name. And nobody has driven a car in your family. I say you can be the first. I say you can be the first. Nobody has done a big business in your family. You can be the first.